And we're live. Hey everyone, this is hikkipedia, and today I have my good friend Quinton with me, and we're going to be reviewing live the Koda Kumi Blu-ray. Well, you have the Blu-ray, right? The DVD.
Yes.
Her last Blu-ray. Live DVD for the Walk of My Life tour. Yeah, I should hold mine up too. I'll just keep holding mine up and hope it's the thumbnail.
Twinsies.
Oh, mine's like a paper case. Did you get a plastic case?
Oh yeah, mine. No, it's just I keep the sleeve it comes in. I don't know if you got a sleeve for yours, but
oh,
it looks plastic, but it's really just a sleeve, and it has like the sticker still.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm a collector.
Yeah, I know. You always love leaving me comments saying that I smash my stuff and I treat my stuff badly.
It was one time, and I pulled you aside, and I had to let you know.
Okay, so Quinton, do you want to like introduce yourself a bit to the people watching?
Okay. So, those of you that don't know me by name, you will know me if you're on Tumblr. A few years ago, I started a blog called first it was called Naku, and then I changed it to Mega Naku, and originally Naku was. We cut out. Oh no. Are you there? Should I keep going? Hello? Okay.
Oh my god, sorry, my connection got dropped.
Oh, okay. So, I don't know, should I start over?
Yeah, what happened?
Okay, I'll start over. So, a few years ago, I started a blog on Tumblr. You probably know me by this, it's called Naku. And it was signified that I was a Namie stan and also a Koda Kumi stan. And then I kind of like built off from there, so I was like Mega Naku, because then I got introduced to like, the world of Meg, if you don't know her, she was produced under Nakata, who does perfume. She actually did that first, but whatever. So I liked her, and then I started trolling people a little bit, and I said some comments about IU. I'm not a big fan of IU, though. I do like some of her music, but I said some things about like maybe she should stop lip syncing, or she should just like stop in general. People really took that offensively, and people liked that, and I got a few followers from that. So, and I did that for a few years. And I did a couple of YouTube things, not too much, and maybe I'll get back into it, but for now yeah. I am working a lot, so I don't have enough time to troll your faves, sorry.
Yeah, I miss you. That's how we met, by the way. We met on Tumblr, and
I think you agreed with me or something, and like, but you didn't want to say it publicly, yeah. So like, you sent me like a ask, and then that's how we started talking. So, hate brings the true friends.
So, do you want to?
Anne and hate.
Do you want to tell them like how old you are or what state you live in?
Yeah, I'm. So I'm 22, I'm from the United States, I live in Connecticut. Where you can find me is usually in your nearest dumpster. Besides my tricks. Just kidding, usually I'm at home and I'm watching J-pop videos. I'm a big collector.
Yeah, so Quinton actually knows a lot more about J-pop than I do, and he really like schooled me on J-pop when I first started my YouTube and my blog and was like, girl! You have so many bootlegs. It's like, oh god, I didn't know.
It was so bad, I could actually be like, that's a bootleg, and I didn't even like, own that one. Like, the one that you had, I think it was Best Fiction, and I was like, that's not right.
Like, I was like, I don't know if this is legit or not. You're like, oh my god, idiot.
Well, I had to let you know, now you're really great, and you know, no one, I mean, you don't just like go off like just knowing like, oh yeah, that's a bootleg. It's kind of like, I like stalked these J-pop bitches for a while, and I just kind of like just knew what it looked like and what like you like had like it was funny because like That one in particular, you didn't have a legitimate case, but you had the actual CDs.
Oh, okay.
Which was interesting. So it was like maybe like someone like trying to make like a like it was like legit like halfway. I don't know, but hey.
So is there is there some tip you have when you're looking at J-pop stuff? Like obviously when you ordered online from the legit sites, you get the legit copies, but you know, if you're shopping in like Chinatowns and stuff, that's where I got all my bootlegs. So like what would you look for?
Well, I mean, if it's like an impulse buy kind of thing, like if you're like in Chinatown, all of a sudden you like, because like you have like some sort of like foreknowledge in J-pop and like you see like a Nami album, but you don't know the track listing. So you just like see Nami and you recognize her and you buy it. It's kind of like you're doomed. So I would say like if you ever like do something like that, always like pull out your phone, scroll Wikipedia, and like, cause most of the track listings are correct there. And you can just be like, okay, well, this is what I'm looking for. I have a friend, Patrick, shout out. he actually bought like a bootleg and he knew it was, but he still wanted to buy it anyways. And it was the Play album for Namie, and it had like live tracks on there from like 1992. So like, I mean, it was kind of a funny thing, but like that's what happened. So you need to be careful and make sure. Look for like sometimes like you can get like a real like Korean print, and that's for real. I mean, I personally don't go for those, but they'll have like a seal, like a little shiny seal of authenticity on it that you can go by that.
Okay.
Or just look for copyright information. If it's super detailed, then you know you got the right one.
Yeah, when I bought all my bootlegs, it was before I even had a smartphone. Like I was really late to the game in getting an iPhone, as you know. Like I didn't get it until like a year ago. So even if I wanted to, I wouldn't have been able to look up like what the real things looked like. So I was like, this is a Namie DVD.
I have her face and it's like some chick like that's kind of brown looking, that kind of looks like her.
Okay, so do you want to get started on the review?
Okay. So do you want to go first or?
Yeah, so I guess we already kind of like introduced what it is. I mean, we got off topic, so I'll flash it again for anyone that's just showing up. Yeah. Woo! Ooh. It's the Walk of My Life live Blu-ray. So just tell me real quick, did you like it or did you not like it?
I generally liked the show. I really did. Yeah. I think the show in general was a little bare bones compared to her older shows, especially if you're talking about Trick. I guess we'll get to that because I did put it in one of my notes. So I will say something about that. But it was a good show. It was a good show. I don't think like it was like as highly produced as you would expect, considering that it was backed by Mercedes-Benz.
Mm.
But it's still a great show. Her energy made a lot of it, and yeah.
So how did you even get into Koda Kumi? Like, how did you get into J-pop, and how did you sort of start out?
So it started with a little movie called Pokemon 2000.
What is it called? Pokemon?
Pokemon 2000. Okay. Yeah, Pokemon. So, Pokemon 2000 in the Japanese version, because where I was living, there was like an otaku down the street I was friends with, and I had to be like literally six, but he, back when like eBay wasn't really a thing, and like it was the way people like kind of distributed like media was like through VHSs that was like really bad quality. They would like have like swap sites. That's how he got it, and the ending theme for it was Toi et Moi from Namie. So now he was actually like the first one to pop my cherry at such a young age. It's such a great bitch. So Toi et Moi was the theme song for that, and it was the ending theme, and I really like that song. So even though it's like probably one of her worst songs, but it was like her first R&B song, and I really liked it. Like technical R&B song, it wasn't really, it was really pop. But yeah, so that's where I started. Kind of dropped off after that. Like after 2001, I stopped. And then Final Fantasy X-2 came out. And everyone knows that Koda Kumi did the Japanese version of that song, A Real Emotion. And then it was covered by Jade from Sweetbox for their American release. But when they were hyping for the American release. They were using the Japanese version. And that's how I got into her. So, and cool. It's been history since then.
So that's really young, but that's really young age to get started, So I guess we can start at the beginning of the show, like the live, Koda Kumi live.
Okay.
So I think she's kind of known for her entrances on the stage. She kind of does these big, crazy entrances. So what did you think of her entrance in this instance?
Okay, well, her entrance, I really liked it, I think this is a recurring theme. I don't know if it's like, I don't know if it was purposeful or not, but like she already did something like this. It wasn't like an entrance for like the actual intro of the show, but she did do this sort of thing. She came out on a Mercedes-Benz. It was like, you know, floating up in the air, being suspended. And she's on top of that. She did sort of something similar with on the Trick Tour. She came out with Hurry Up, and she was on a motorcycle, and she's one of those classic microphones. So I mean, I really liked that when it first did it. I liked it now because it's kind of like, you know, Mercedes Benz, and maybe she got a rep, and it was beautiful. I love the costume. I think it was really nice because it was like a screen before that, and it ripped in like the logo of Mercedes Benz and to reveal her. Mm-hmm. So it was really cool. I liked that.
Yeah.
And what song was that? That was You Can Keep Up With Me, which I fucking hate that song.
I know.
But it was better because it was live, I think.
Yeah, exactly. No, like I was saying in my review, I really didn't like that song. So when I saw it was opening, I was like, but like the live version was so good. I was like, okay, I kind of like it a bit more though. And that was the case for quite a few songs that I didn't really like off the album. Like just seeing her perform.
I was just going to say that. Yeah, I think vocally she knocks out of the park. I think most of the time that song in particular, because it's a really hard song, it's like she does that screamy like vibrato thing, like no, I don't know, she does that, she should no, and she fucking kicks the shit out of that part, and I love it, and I think that's what made me like it because it was just like I am impressed with the vocals. Mm-hmm. But otherwise, the song's garbage, sorry. Performance was good, though.
Oh, and by the way, I haven't seen the Trick Tour, and you've already mentioned it a couple times, so I just want to tell you now that I haven't seen it.
Wow, I'm really disappointed, because that's probably, like, her best tour. Like, in terms of, because, like, I almost, like, compare all her tours to that tour, because, like, that one had the most, like, flash and stuff. It was, like, dress change, like there was this one part called, you know that song, This Is Not a Love Song, that she does? It's like this magic trick that she does. Oh, it's, I'm gonna spoil it for you, but I really think you should go in J-pop Suki and download it, or like hit me up and I'll send you a copy or something. I think I still have my DVDs for it. I'll like send it to you if you need to. It's so good.
Yeah, I got kicked off J-pop Suki. So
that's right.
I'm gonna buy it. I'm just gonna buy it. I'm gonna try finding a book off in Japan while I'm there or something.
Oh yeah, okay.
JAM Entertainment in the comments is saying I would have thought Mercedes would be the first track. That was the second track.
Yeah, okay. So good segue. Thanks for doing it for us.
So yeah, it was kind of like they kind of tied together. She was wearing the same outfit and she was like kind of dancing around the car and whatever. Like during the first song, the car like lowers down from the ceiling. And I thought that was cool.
Yeah, that was cool. And going to Mercedes, I think like the performance was decent. It was good. It wasn't like anything like to like gag over, but like until like she got on top of the car and it was like going towards the satellite stage, that was really nice. I like that. That and then that part reminds me of like Madonna when on Sick and Sweet Tour, like literally like the second track, like what was it called? Rolls Royce comes out and she like rides that into the satellite and then she does some dancing on it. But it wasn't as involved this time. However, it's still a really, really nice touch. And then the dancing got kind of sultry and nice, and like, and it was really nice. So then it started getting really good.
Yeah.
And her fur coat was like so nice. I was like, that's like the epitome of decadence.
I kept thinking of that character from Monsters, Inc. She looked like Sully. It's like this massive,
oh my
green
god!
Thing.
It's like just like a couple like purple dots. And she's like,
yeah,
doppelganger.
Okay, not to derail from the live tour, but Jalen XO in the chat is asking, what do you both think of Koda Kumi's album Universe?
It's hit and miss. Like, it's more like than hate. And then there's if I can remember the track listing right, it was like, Welcome to My World, love that song. It's a really good like opener track too. I think she did it on the Universe Tour as an opener and on that premium live show thing. If you got the fan club edition for, Winter of Love, it was the opener for that as well.
Oh, okay.
Good opener track. And then I think it went to Universe. That's a good track. And then it was like kind of filler. Lick Me was good. And then filler. and then I got to, what was it, Physical Thing, and there's another one, I think Ecstasy. It's like there's always like a couple of good songs, and then the rest were like meh. And then, you know, it was always the singles that were really good for that one, because I think a lot of singles came out for that album.
I honestly love Universe. It's like in my top three by her.
Oh wow, okay.
I haven't listened to it in a long time, so maybe if I re-listen to it now. Like, I haven't listened to it since before, like, the last three albums have come out, so maybe if I listen to it now, I might change my mind.
I wonder if I have it on my phone. I'm not going to do that, but I would cheat. I know I have it on my phone. I want to know. It's bothering me now. But, and I remember, like, liking the album. It wasn't like a Black Cherry for me. Like, Black Cherry was, like, it, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And then before that, it was like Affection and Fill My Mind. Those two were like my favorites.
Really?
I mean, Old Coup is actually my favorite. And then it got into like Happiness is really good.
Mm-hmm.
And then that one I can like listen to pretty much all the way to the end, except for Poppin' Lip Cocktail. And I have a note about it, so I'm not even gonna get into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I actually didn't start listening to Koda Kumi until Kingdom.
Oh, wow.
And that was
okay,
my first album.
Okay, so
that's
2008.
Yeah.
I think, or 2008.
So her older stuff, like Affection and Feel My Mind, took me like a lot longer to get into because it was like getting used to that whole like 90s, early 2000s J-pop sound.
Yeah, like, she was, like, urban queen. Like, she, I mean, I wish she was more popular because I think, like, that's when, like, she had, like, a lot more quality in her music. Not that she doesn't have now, but I feel like she chooses a lot of fodder tracks and not, like, really, like, good, like, tracks that really like, get people's attention for, like, other than single tracks.
Mm-hmm.
That makes any sense?
Yeah.
So, okay, yeah, so, like, Seven to My World, Can We Go Back, Superstar, You're So Beautiful, Like Me, Work It Out, No Way, and then those are like a string of like awesome songs, and then it was like Stay, meh, comes up, meh, Physical Thing, all right, XC, all right, Universe, all right, and then It's All Up, and then Alive, like why didn't you have to end like that?
Yeah, I don't care for Alive, but I really like Physical Thing and Ecstasy and Universe. I thought those are all really good tracks.
Yeah.
Anyway. Okay, let's go back to this.
Right, okay, derailed.
Yeah. So then we had the first interlude movie.
You know, I made a comment about the first interlude movie, the intro before the intro, when she comes out.
Yeah.
I like the futuristic city thing.
Mm-hmm.
I do.
And how it was showing, like her videos and all of the big screens, like, in with
yeah,
Alex
that
City
was
really cool.
Yeah, I like that. That was really cool. It reminded me, actually, the promos for Feel from Nami A, because she had a lot of that going on, too. I remember when she was around the city, it wasn't even, like, she wasn't even in the song for the music video for Alive, either.
Yeah.
She was just, like, it was just, like, her face, like...
She's like, I'm not making a video for this song.
Like, what the fuck are you asking me to do? Like, no. So yeah, the second interlude. Ingrish has improved until she says, "Party's waiting." Like,
come on.
Come on. Always late. And I said in my card, "I hate that bitch that made her wait." She had a fucking punch face. Like, sorry, I'm late. Like, bitch, like, how many times I knock on the door, you can at least bite me in so I can sit on your fucking couch. Like,
yeah.
Like, so rude. Like,
the girl doesn't even, like, say anything either. I love how she always has, like, foreign people in her videos. Oh, not always, but, like, often, like, it's two foreign girls, like, two white girls come out, and she's, like, driving in the car with them. They have no speaking parts.
It's just, like, it's almost like that Rebecca Black music video.
Yeah.
Like, she's, like, it's like that pedophile black guy who's driving the car, and she's just like,
she's like, these are my bitches.
It's dangerous.
Yeah, I appreciated her English in those clips. She really stepped it up.
Yeah, she did. I mean, I wish she would do that in songs. I feel like, you know, she puts more effort into like speaking English in her interludes, and no one pays attention to it except for us.
Yeah.
And then like the songs where everyone comes to actually see her for it, it's just like, that's pretty. Back cherry. Crap your hands, everybody. And like, that's like actually in a song. It's not even live. She says, "Crap your hands, everybody." That's forever CD.
Crock device. Oh, I'm gonna get more comments that I'm racist.
We're not racist, it's just that's what it is. It's English, and that's, I mean, you have accent, whatever. I mean, like, so do Spanish people. I'm Puerto Rican, and you can tell me I'm racist because I say like Spanish people have accents, they can't say like my name is Quinton, they say Quinton. Like, I mean, this is how it is, like, whatever.
Yeah, but she's working on it, so it's all good.
So it's all good.
So she comes out and she does house party.
Yeah.
And what was her outfit at that part? She was wearing a different outfit, right?
All she did was she took off a little, like, okay, so I think she's kind of lazy. She's done this before in her hall tours where like she has like this one main outfit, and that's what it was. It was like this one main outfit that she just like kind of takes something off really quick, and then it's a different outfit, but it's not.
Yeah.
If you're paying attention, it's not. Yeah. So she had like this like thing underneath the coat that she was wearing before, and like she just took that off, and it revealed kind of like a more like a see-through like pattern-y thing. It was nice.
Oh, no, she had
It was like white, and then she just literally took it, and she like literally, it's like a vest. And she just took it off, and that was like, because the bottom's still the same, but like, it, you know, it. Then she takes off the reveal, like the see-through kind of thing.
Yeah.
For the top.
Okay, yeah, I like that outfit. The second outfit with she's wearing like a jeweled.
Yeah, yeah, and it's really pretty.
Bikini type of thing. Yeah.
Oh, the earring was really pretty too. I like that.
Yeah.
It's like this. I don't know. It goes all around her lobe or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so house party was cool. I was kind of like, okay,
next done song.
Done with the songs off this album, actually.
I don't like house party either. I said, sounds better live. Dancing was pretty good. I think, you know, I mean, whatever. It was cute, you know, it was just kind of a fun song. Not that it's a great song, but. Mm-hmm. It's good for a show. It's not good for the album, I don't think.
Yeah. Yeah, like I said in my review that I like the song, but it doesn't feel like a Koda Kumi song. She's like hardly even singing on the track.
Oh yeah, it's all like a group shouting. It's like literally her whole team is like, come on, we're gonna be in a song together.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, well, good idea.
So yeah, next song was a medley. It was the first medley, which was
of like Butt, four.
Yeah, Shake It Up and Triple D.
DDD. I say DDD. I don't know. I mean, I whatever. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, they say triple D at the beginning of the song. They're like, triple D.
Oh, do they? Oh, they do. Yeah. Triple D, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? They do say that because I remember watching it for the first time and I was thinking, like, those are big ass hits. I really like this medley though, because I had like some of my favorite songs. I really like Triple D, and I like hold on, let me look at it. I like Butt. Oh yeah, okay. So I like Butt because that song's always been banging for me, and I like that she brought back the original choreography from Black Cherry.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, she did it for the second encore for that show, and it was like she did it with this weird skit, and I guess they were playing a game or something like that, and then she just comes out and does Butt. And everyone's like, oh my god, a new album. So, and then she did, you know, it was nice. I like that. So I like the original choreography for that one. It was worked out.
Do you normally like the medleys or?
I think like, so one reason why I'm like more of a Namie fan than Kuz is because like, I feel like Namie like gives a lot of her songs like the spotlight it deserves. Mm-hmm. And like that was a good medley, but I feel like all those songs could have been like individual performances in itself, not like run in to mm-hmm. each other. Like, cause it was like Butt got most of it, and then it was like Shake It Up got like 2 seconds, and then it was DDD and it got the rest.
Mm-hmm.
And like those are some of my favorite songs from her, and yeah. I would like to hear the whole thing and actually see a performance, and not just like, you know, walk around the stage, do a couple moves, and then like, you know, next song.
Mm-hmm.
And I just feel like it's kind of a cop-out to, like, you know, fit everything into, like, a two-hour show. You can definitely make it longer. This is the Walk of My Life tour. It's your 15th anniversary tour. Make mm-hmm. it worth the money. And she always just does, like, those medleys, and it fucking pisses me off. I hate short versions. I hate it. And it's like, just make it a 30-song set. Like, Namie does it, and she's older than you, and, like, I mean, okay. I mean, this is another review for another time, but, like, the new tour, she did, like, 28 songs. And she, like, knocked it out of the park. Like, dancing was all back and everything. Like, she wasn't doing the lazy, like, oh, okay. And it was, like, almost like a Gibby Moore performance before.
Oh, really?
Spears. Like, you know, yeah. Like, it was where she, like, you know, do a couple moves, walk around. It's, like, kind of lazy. You know, she, like, danced the whole time.
Oh, okay. Part.
So, going with that, she's able to do it. Cool. You're totally able to do it. And considering your album sales, you might want to, like, put in the work.
I know. That's the thing is, like, I appreciate the medleys because, you know, you do get to hear those three songs that you might not have heard two of them if she like kept her set list as it was. But at the same time, like, I know she's capable of doing a 30 song set. So
yeah, it's like,
give us a longer set.
Yeah. I mean, like, if you really count it by like tracks, there's only 24 songs. There's only like 24 songs, but like she does more than that, but it's like, just, it's not like you couldn't make them into their own just performances, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's what bothered me. But, I mean, as far as medley go, it's good. It's a good medley. I'll take it.
Mm-hmm. Did you get the Bon Voyage tour?
I did.
Okay.
And she did, and that... Oh, okay. So, when she finally did Rock Your Body, finally, I've been waiting for it for, like, literally years, ever since... the album came out. I think it was like Grow Into One. I think it was on Grow Into One. Yeah. It needed to be on a tour, but it wasn't on a tour until that. And it was like kind of a weird, like, nautical version of the song. It was kind of stripped down a little bit, and it would like lasted for like 3 seconds. And then she the next song. It was a shortened version. It really bothered me. It was like, like, you're dying to hear. If she like gives them little snippets, like, just kidding. You're not going to get the whole thing. You really thought you were that lucky?
God damn it. Sorry, I'm being distracted by the comments.
I know, right? Like, my celebrity is just, like, making it blow up right now.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Am I getting a lot of hate?
No, you're not. Actually, you're getting a lot of love. Everyone says you're hilarious.
Oh, yay! Yeah. Great.
Oh, shit. Okay, I'll have to fix that later. Thanks, Shane. I just have a broken link in my description, but...
Oh, I actually can't even see any, like, is it normal for me not to have any of the group chat happening?
Yeah, now? I'll send you the link to the, you just have to go to, like, the video page.
Oh, okay, don't worry about it. I'm not even worried about it.
Okay, so the next song was Dance Interlude, Introduction, Walk of My Life, and the Interlude Dance.
You know, I skip that. I don't care about that stuff usually. I watch it once and then I skip it the subsequent watches. I just don't really, it's cool, but like I don't care about the dancers. I know like there's like a fandom for the dancers sometimes.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I like him. I hope he comes back. And like, oh, he's so cute. So much chemistry with him and Koo. Is something going on the side or something like that? I know. Mm-hmm. I saw a lot of that before. The only person I really cared about like that was Shinosuke, and he's gone now. Like, I'm really sad. I thought he was like the guy that like kind of looked American, but he's like definitely Japanese.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. He was daddy for a while, but now he's gone. So.
Yeah, I recognized a few of her other dancers that she's been using for quite a while.
Oh yeah, like I think there's a one girl, like that's her home girl. I can't remember her name right now, but she's really pretty. The other one, the only other dancer I really like stuck out of me, and I didn't even notice her until like I saw like this comment on YouTube. I was watching like the Black Cherry performance on Black. It was like Black Cherry like intro, for Black Cherry perform of the Black Cherry tour, and like they were doing like. Cause she comes out like in like water and then she has to go do a quick change.
Mm-hmm.
And while she's doing that, the dancers are like coming out, they're coming out from under the stage, and like one of them comes out like that, and like she's actually kind of a little heavier.
Mm-hmm.
And like someone's like, is she pregnant? Like someone said, is she pregnant? That was the only reason why I even noticed her. And then like the comment, the poster was like, no, she's not pregnant, she's just a little chubby, that's it. And her name was Jungle, of course, and she's so cool. I like her. They don't give her a lot of screen time on the tours that she's on, but I really like her.
Yeah, I remember her. I remember noticing her because she was like a thicker dancer. I was like, that's so cool.
She's really pretty. I think she's really pretty, and like she was like sexy. I guess. I mean, I'm gay. I don't like. Guess.
Okay. So next up was Lippy.
Love Lippy. So that's one of my favorite tracks on the album. It's like second favorite.
Same.
Dancing was really good. I like the dance in between the vocal parts. Good vocals. It was just a solid routine.
Was that the one that had the really cool background video where it's like lots of shots of her face?
Yeah, it, you know what, actually it was so cool, apparently. It was probably one of the bonus movies for the Blu-ray. Like if you, I don't know if it was on the DVD.
Yeah.
But yeah, you could actually like watch it. I guess, you know what, someone use that like as the official music video. I mean, that's the closest we're gonna get.
Mm-hmm.
I saw the same thing happen for like Black Candy on the Deja Vu tour. That was like she used one of the background movies on there too. And someone's like, music video.
Yeah, I love that song too.
And good energy too, really, really good energy. That was like one of her most energetic performances on the tour.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so next up was the next movie clip. And I started getting nervous, I think it was this one, because she like says bye to her white friends, and then she's like pulls up to the like image control center or whatever it's called.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
I was like, what the hell? Because recently she had said that she never wanted to be like sexy and have her sexy image. I was like, oh my god, is this her way of being like, I'm gonna go in here and change my image? She's gonna come out like dressed like a grandma or something.
Well, I mean, sorta. I mean, like, remember, like, behind her, like, it was like that person in the black, like, veil shadow thing. Wasn't that her?
Yeah. Okay. Why did they even bother veiling her? Like, she puts her hand out. She has like these massive nails. I'm like, that's obviously Koda Kumi.
Like, I mean, like, at this point, like, older, much more mature.
She's like, girl.
Nails.
Put some pants on.
You know, I actually interpreted this interlude like. As when I first watched it, like I thought, because I didn't know that she actually said like she never really wanted to do the sexy image. She was kind of like, you know, kind of thing to get sales.
Yeah.
I interpreted when I first watched it was like, I don't know, is she like hinting that she got plastic surgery or like forced her into plastic surgery? Because like I just interpreted this whole like walk of my life, just like I'm finally free. Like she might like got out of a contract thing, and like that's what, like it was kind of like a sad story kind of thing, and then she's finally out, kind of like the Kesha thing, but like she actually stuck it through. And no, that wasn't a joke. No, I mean, it's super funny, but like, I mean, it wasn't like a dig in Kesha because that was terrible. But it's just that like, you know, she stuck it out, and now she's finally able to like have more control and creative control. I don't know. That's why I got out of the song itself, and that's what I thought later. I thought she was from a plastic surgery or some shit. I don't know. I was concerned for her at first, and I interlude. I wasn't sure what was going on. They were like, choose your style. And she's like, I noticed like later on in the interludes when they like show like the styles that she's trying to choose, like she's like rock, and then it was like a pop out, like it was like a pop like costume, and it was just funny. It was like, I don't think they knew. it just made me laugh. It was just like rock, and it was like, I definitely remember her singing Universe in this song, in this costume, because it's all like past costumes. They're all tours.
Just in the movie clips, by the way, guys, if you haven't seen it, like she's not wearing the same outfits during the tour. It's brand new outfits, but yeah. So she, in the movie clip, she goes into this place where there's like this creepy guy who again is like a foreigner, and he doesn't have a speaking part, and it's very like long and drawn out, and there's no talking. There's just Japanese subtitles, and it's just like Ku like looking around thoughtfully, and she's like, She's like looking at the guy, and she's like looking at the screen. Like,
and he hands her contract. I think he hands her a contract, and she signs it too.
Yeah.
And then eventually, I don't know. I mean, we're spoiling it though. Really deep metaphors and stuff that's in it. But yeah, I don't know. I think it's kind of symbolic. And I think she might have gotten out of the contract she hated, and that's why this was spurred the walk of my life kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm pretty curious about that. Like the way. Like when I heard Walk of My Life, the song, I just kind of assumed she meant like she had like accepted herself, and she, you know, when she first started her career, she was like a little chubbier, and maybe she's like gained more self-confidence since then, and I don't know.
I mean, that's probably true too. I mean, I know that in the past like interviews, like when like, you know, subbing was a thing and stuff like that, you guys, whoever's a subber out there, fucking take this tour and like take all the tours and like, can someone please sub her MCs? I want to know what she says. Like, I'm an American. I don't want to know. I don't want to learn Japanese. They need to speak English for me.
So, well, I understood about half of what she was saying, the MCs, but just study Japanese.
I don't know. I know I really want to. I just, you know, I have excuses. So, so she goes into hands with this, and hands is beautiful no matter what. Yeah. Every time, it's actually one of my favorite ballads. It's the one I'll like actually listen to every time it comes up. It was a little stripped down this time, and I like that they use the Spanish guitar. And
we should mention that she changes her outfit.
She does change. Yeah, she changes her outfit. Like usually during, like, okay, at this point, every interlude she changes her outfit. Mm-hmm. And yeah, she changes her outfit. It's a, you know, it's this. This is the ballad segment of the show. She always has the ballad segment, and it always like bores me to sleep because I don't do ballads seriously.
Hands came out in like this floor length champagne color jewel encrusted dress. And I've been trying to figure out if that's my favorite outfit of the show, or her previous one that was like the jeweled bikini with like the mesh midriff thing.
I think my favorite, I guess we'll get into it when it comes, but it's the one she wears for Dance in the Dark. And it's not Dance in the Dark, sorry, Dance in the Rain. But it's like, yeah, it's kind of like, it's like, but it's like champagne, and you don't like, but you don't see most of it because it's covered by like, it's like there's a, buckles, and it like these buckles are like actually another dress on it, if you notice. I don't know, I mean, the DVD is like so blurry to me at this point. I all I've been watching is Blu-ray, so I can't even see the detail that the DVD show anymore at this point. It's all blurry to me. But those of you who watched the DVD version, it's like a dress covering a dress. It's really pretty, actually. It sounds ugly the way I describe it, but yeah, And that's green with the champagne color, and it just really looks nice, and it blows really nice, because, like, I think in the next song, what, Sometimes Dreams Come True, she's, like, you know, kind of doing the rock thing, and, like, she's, like, standing, and there's, like, the Beyonce breeze coming through.
That was cool.
Yeah, that was really nice.
She looked really epic when she, like, grabs the mic, and she, like, sticks her leg out. And the dress is, like, blowing back.
this whole, like, segment is really good. I just don't do ballads. I like to dance.
I liked that ballad segment more than the Japanese tour. I like the ballad segment on the Japanese tour. I found that part really boring. Like, it just kind of died.
And you know what? Like, she went into, like, the... I guess they separated her MC from the actual show. They, like, cut a lot of the MC because she, like, talked for, like, almost an hour. So, like, they had it as a bonus track on the second disc.
Okay.
So, like, you know what, I saw that it got cut, and I was like, yeah, this ain't for me. So I don't really remember much of it. I'm not gonna lie.
I like this ballad segment a lot because I thought Sometimes Dreams Come True kind of picked it up in the middle. It wasn't just like these really like slow, like dead ass ballads for like three or four songs. The next song was Walk of My Life.
Yeah, Walk of My Life, Piano Skills. That's what I wrote. Piano Skills. And this is where she does the multi-instrumentalist thing, and it's really nice. It's, I mean, not a lot of other artists do it. I mean, like, besides, like, the guitar thing. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, at least she played it. You know, she's obviously a novice, but it was clearly live, and, like, she did her thing, and her vocals were really, really good. It was really strong. And it wasn't like, I don't know, I feel like in the album track, like the album version of it, it was kind of like, I don't know, she kind of got really shouty. This part, I think she kind of fixed it, and it felt just really nice. It was like a really good mix of shout with like actual emotion and like technique. So if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely would have been more impressed if she performed the whole song on the piano, like, solo. But when she got up, I was like, what?
What I don't like, though, is the fact that, like, I hate when they have the piano move across the stage. Like, oh, so dynamic. Like, that doesn't impress me. I don't like it, but it's okay.
Yeah. And, yeah, she did display a lot of emotion in that song. I think she does that very, very well in her records and as well as the live performances. She really, like, isn't afraid to display her emotion.
Yeah, she definitely, like, cries, like, almost every tour.
That's what I was wondering, like, every show is she crying?
Or is it just, like, the finals that they really, or, like, yeah. Or is it, like, just for the show? I don't know. Like, just for, like, you know, the recorded show. I don't know. But, I mean, for us in America viewing it, I appreciate it because I feel like she's, like, vulnerable, and like it's I feel like I know her a little bit better. Like, she really feels like, you know, this song speaks to her. It speaks to me too. Feels.
Yeah. What was next?
So
Always?
She pulled someone up for Always. Yeah. It was like, you know, the song menu thing. She's been doing that for like a little while now. I think from the Kingdom Tour, that's when she brought up the song menu. For the ballads, and I don't know, I don't remember what song she had to choose from. I think it was, you know what, it was on the Blu-ray. So it's Futaride, and then I Know Uta, of course, and Rain. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So yeah, those were, no, I think it's just...
In Brave.
So those were the songs.
I love when she brings them up on stage. It's like my favorite part of the whole show.
Yeah, I mean, I think Happy Dance Tour was, like, my favorite because, like, she, like, well, I don't know. Now that I think about it, I think that's just the most recent one that I watched, so it sticks out in my head more. But, like, when she, like, jumps onto that fence thing that they're tied up on, and, like, she's just, like, I was like, oh, my God!
I know.
Like, what does it take? You know, I want to do it. I really want to do it one day. And you have a chance because you're actually going to see her, right?
I'm trying so hard to get tickets for when I'm in Japan, but...
You know what's a good resource I found? It's like killing me to say this, but AHS, Ayumi Hamasaki, Sakai, the forum. There's like a, because like, you know, a lot of, they're really, really diehard fans on there, and like a lot of the people who go see her on there, like, there's a lot of people that want to go see her, and they like post like FAQs and like tutorials on like where you should go to get tickets, how you should do it. There's like, and so check there. And that's for everyone watching too. Like, if you're going to Japan and your fave is performing, really, I highly recommend you go on there, like make an account, even if it's a dummy account, just to go see the shit and find your answer, because they actually have like really good resources on there. And just don't say anything in the comments, because you get attacked. You get attacked really crazily. It's like, you say like, oh, she could have done better on this. If you're talking about IU, you really want to talk about IU, don't, because unless you're like eating out her butthole, there's no, there's like no winning. You're like, you like, you get like a warning for like nothing. Like, this, I got banned in 3 days. Like, I think like they realized who I was, and like, I wasn't even doing anything. I swear I wasn't like trying to start shit. And like, they realized who I was, and they're like, yeah, just get him out of here. Like, she's just like, squirm out. Like,
well, that's why I ended up leaving the Utada Net forums, because like, people were just jumping down my throat for like the dumbest shit.
For being real, like, I don't understand why that. Like, if you're like real, if you like even like display any sort of like, you know, like, if you're being objective instead of like totally biased, like, that's not no. You gotta be a stan or you're out. That's
yeah.
So, I mean, like, I get it, but, like, y'all gotta chill, because they don't even know you exist. like, literally, I mean, come on, like, IU hasn't toured America, like, Namie, Ku. For all I know, the only thing that, like, even, like, exists for them on the planet is, like, Japan and Taiwan. That's it. They don't know what America is, and they don't care. So they don't care about you. Don't stand so hard, and just be real. Like, I mean, if you like, you liked it, but someone else didn't like it. So just be like, hey, bye.
Yeah,
I will say that like the IU fandom is really good about like archiving, because I found like bootlegs. I should have found bootlegs of like a whole tour on there. Like, people, they recorded it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I found like people, they got rehearsal footage, they got rehearsal audio for songs. Mm-hmm. Like, I think it was like for a countdown live for like 2013, which was supposed to do Heart Place.
Mm-hmm.
I listened to it. It sounded really good, by the way. They're like, I guess they're listening outside of Yokogi, and they were just like, they recorded it, and that shit like didn't even make the final set list. So like, so they have a really good archive, and like, you know, just like, I wish like the fandoms were like that, I probably would still be more active.
Mm-hmm.
Because at this point, I'm just like trying to collect it, like Namie bootlegs. I have like three, but it's so hard to find.
The Utada fandom was like that during her US tour. Like, there were bootlegs of all her of all her US performances, and so that was cool. But yeah, after that, I think
on J-Pop Suki, I saw like they actually allowed like one bootleg, and it was the Fillmore show in the flesh. Because like someone like recorded that whole thing, and it was really good quality one, I guess. So, and then she released it. Then they had to take it down.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. But yeah, going back to the people they bring up on stage, I'm always like crying because I'm picturing it as me, and they start crying, and then I'm like, oh my god.
Oh my god. And it was like, but she doesn't like do like, I don't know, I wish she did like a sexy part, but she didn't.
I know, in Japanese, I was screaming, I was like showing my boyfriend, I'm like, look at this fucking freak, she's like, she brings up a guy and a girl, and the girl is like crying. But
I think it's two guys and a girl, it's three people, I remember, I think it was two guys and a girl.
Okay.
Yeah, she brings up more people on those ones than she does like the song by me ones.
Yeah. I remember one of the guys in Japanese is trying to look cool the whole time.
Oh yeah, he's like, yeah, yeah. He's like that. And it was like some dumb bitch that cries, like, stop crying. I remember this one time, I think it was I think, oh, it was the trick tour. Like, they pull up a girl, and, like, they pull up three people, and, no, four, I think, and, it was for Shake It, and, like, she, you know, they dance them? Around. Huh?
You, like, humping them and stuff?
Yeah, yeah, there was actually one of the dancers, and it was, like, the fuckliest dancer, too. Like, who like, puts his, like, junk in between this guy's, like, on, like, so it's, like, his junk is on top of his, like, knee and, like, thigh, and, like, he starts humping it for a second. And then, like, it just walks away. So like, she, like, chose the girl that was crying. She had to chose the girl that was crying. So, like, they bring her up on stage, and, you know, because they tied him up against, like, the chairs and stuff like that, and she's, like, straddling her, and then she actually stops singing to be like, "Dashabu, dashabu," and, like, she's like, calm down, and, like, it's okay, and, like, she, like, tries to kiss her, and she's, like, totally being, like, just rebellious, and, like, I was like, kick her off the stage. That bitch is, like, totally unworthy. Like, stop crying, bitch. You should be, like, sucking her tit and, like, get along. Hey, you know, like, go along with the show. Like, what the hell? Like, you should be sexy with her.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. Yeah, I'd be, like, screaming. I'd be like, yes! Me!
Maybe that's, like, the American, like, I mean, like, the North American in us. I don't know. Like, it's just kind of, like, we're, like, not, like, inhibited in emotions, and the only thing you can show is, like, crying or something. I don't know, whatever. I mean, I'm not gonna get into it, because that's just another can of worms that people are gonna say racist for.
Yeah.
So, like,
Did you watch the bonus clips of, like, the other, they included the bonus clips of other people that get pulled up, and she performs the other songs?
Yeah, I did. My favorite was, I think, I mean, I really, this is such, like, a cop-out choice too. It's like, I know Uta, because she does that one all the time.
I know,
but that one was my favorite one.
Okay. Yeah, I was kind of meh about Brave. Like,
I don't like Brave. Rain
cares about that.
Rain, I don't like Rain. Get out of here. Futarire, I prefer Yume no Uta. So
I like Futarire out of those tracks. But there's one, all of them are crying and having a meltdown, except this one girl who just looked so dazed.
I think she was, like, singing with her, like, or something. She was, like,
yeah.
She, but, like, she was kind of looking at her, like, come on, she's next to me. Like,
but she would, like, look around the audience, like, oh my god.
Stage fright. You don't have to do anything.
Yeah. Okay.
Next.
Next. Right? Yeah, boys. Dance in the Rain.
Well, no, actually, Gentle Words and Give Me You.
What? Oh, did we skip it?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Skip. Yeah.
I don't like these songs, so I say no.
I like them okay. Not my favorite. I would have preferred a different two songs.
Give Me You was cute, though. I like that one, was the better of the two.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's it about that one.
Yeah.
So now it's Dance in the Rain. Now, this was, like, a highlight of the show, I think, for me. It was great. Vocals was, like, Demi Lovato, like, awesome. I don't know. I don't know. It always reminds me of Demi Lovato. I don't know why, but good song. Even better performance.
Mm-hmm.
And she does
I
that.
The performance.
And, yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead. No, you go ahead.
Okay. I feel like I'm talking a lot. I don't want to, like, dominate your show.
Oh, no, go ahead.
I'm the special guest, so I get to do that.
Yeah.
So special, Ed. So, yeah, it was really good. I liked it a lot. I like the aerial shit. I'm always down for aerial shit. However, originality is lacking in this, because she, like, literally stole the routine from Pink, which did the Grammys in 2009. when Pink did Glitter in the Air, I think that was called. I mean, that was, like, a show-stopping, like, performance, and not that this wasn't either. It was just, like, she could do a little better. So what happens is, like, she, you know, she did the sulks, and then she got into air a little bit, got into position, and then they dropped it down, and the everything goes dark. And in Japan, apparently, people don't have, like, camera phones or flash. So, you know, if you've ever been to a concert, you know, that's all you see when it gets dark. It's just the flash people are taking pictures.
Yeah.
And there, it's actually dark. So, you know, it doesn't spoil the surprise. Well, she comes out and she's all wet and she's spinning and stuff like that. And then she, like, finishes up the song.
and then she exits the stage. Mm-hmm. You know, great performance. I don't know. I mean, like, it was really great. It was really nice. I mean, I wish it was a little bit more in the silks, but I think she's kind of, I remember, like, watching, like, the making of, and she always says she gets really nervous in the air, so she tries to stay out of it for too long. She doesn't try to stay there for too long. Like, it's always, like, for, like, a song, and then she's, like, out. Like, she's, like, she gets, like, really nervous in the air. But, I mean, she's great.
If she gets so nervous, then why does she do it? Like, she does all this crazy shit where she's, like, hanging by one leg and, like, spinning around.
Like, oh, that's right. On, like, Half and That's when she did the hoop. Like, that was a nice exit.
Yeah. After but, like, walk. When Ayu does her little, like, aerial stuff, she's just, like, lifted up in the air, like, 10 feet and sitting, and then they, like, lower her.
And
they're like,
oh, my God. Oh, my God. She did so great. She was tiny. Yeah. Like, I mean, she did some work. I think she just does it for the sake of the show. I mean, like, people pay for a ticket. I mean, you would think, like, three things: a really good show, the singer has pipes, and that they, you know, do things that you normally wouldn't see in the show. And I mean, like, that you don't see. I mean, people were afraid of heights. People were, you know, bitches. And so she gave them bang for their buck. I mean, I think it's good. I mean, if you have to face your fears for 2 seconds, go for it. You can be afraid of when you're not getting paid for it, okay?
Do you remember, I think it was on the Universe tour, where she did an aerial stunt where she, like, gets up on the little podium thing during Can We Go Back?
And
she gets hung up, like, by her feet.
Yeah, by the heels, yeah, they have hooks.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was awesome. I love that. And I mean, she was on top of a bed, so, like, even if she fell, she might have just, like, sprained her neck. Mm-hmm. No,
but then she's like, she still has her mic, and she's, like, belting. I was like, holy fuck.
Like, she sounded better almost. Like, upside down. It was crazy. Yeah. Like, goddess. I don't know. She did really great. I really liked that one.
Yeah, she did a bunch of stuff in this tour where I was like, how is she still holding her mic? Like, through the whole aerial thing, she's like, holding her mic and, like, grabbing the aerial ribbon thing and, like,
and
winding it around her leg.
And wet, too. Yeah. So I wonder, like, did she, like, submerge the mic? Because I know the mics are, like, water resistant, but I don't know if they're going to work that great afterwards. So she probably, like, she's probably, like, under the water. She's like,
maybe they just got a bucket and, like, splashed it on her.
And that'd be lame. Well, I mean, like, I don't think so, because, like, if you see, like, the stage actually, like, kind of, like, comes out, like, it, like, it's like, this is the stage, and then it, like, goes out, and it shows, like, the cool, I guess. I don't know. But it's kind of...
Yeah. Yeah, it was crazy. Buy the DVD just for that, you guys.
Yeah, just for that. If you want to see Kuwait, all right.
Yeah, I Snapchat.
All you one straight guys out there.
Seriously. Okay, so then we had the next movie interlude.
Yeah, this one was where she was like, I think she was like fucking shit up, right? Like, she was like, I don't want to do just one style, I want to do them all. So she does rock, which is pop, and then she does, like, ballad, she does love, and it's like a rock outfit.
Yeah, and it's like obviously the rock segment. I was like, okay,
we got it. And then, I mean, it was cool, I guess. You know, I think that was like her symbolically, like, trying to rebel and, like, you know, Walk of My Life has finally happened. I don't know. So then she goes into Piece of the Puzzle, which is, like, literally second or first fave song on the album.
It's my favorite, yeah.
Yeah, that one, I mean, it's, I read her comments on that, like, because on the fan site, the fan club site, like, she did
Koda
the
Kumi.
Comments.
Yeah.
Koda Kumi, for those of you who don't know, she opened up her fan club to everyone. Now it's international. It's like $25. It's not that expensive, and it's like for a whole year. So, but you get access to, like, her fan club website, her fan club store, which is a bitch to order from, and that's probably a video on itself, on its own.
I've talked about it in my videos.
Okay, sorry.
Okay.
I watched them, just not that often. Oh, sorry. Okay. It's like, because I usually, like, how I knew that you took him out new. Video, I was gonna say song, Tumblr, you post on Tumblr, so I watch it from there, but now I don't have Tumblr anymore, so.
Mm-hmm.
And her fan club store and stuff like that, that's the biggest part, that's why I joined, just to order, honestly.
Yeah.
Because then I got this bag, I got this cool bag from Walk of My Life tour.
That bag is so expensive, I was just looking at the store last night.
I think it went down in price, it was only like $50 now. It has, like, the Walk My Life, like, logo thing, and it's nice. But I don't know.
so it holds a lot of stuff. It's bigger than I thought it would have come. I thought it was going to be like more like a messenger bag kind of size, but it was pretty big. Mm-hmm. I use it whenever I sleep over in Hector's house and stuff. Mm-hmm. So
nice. Nice.
And yeah, piece of puzzle. It was good. I think they did. I think they started doing a live band on this one, right?
Oh, I didn't even notice, but probably, yeah.
I believe they did. It sounded a little bit different than what I expected, so I assume.
Mm-hmm.
Vocals really good. I like the biggest part of that performance was the backdrop.
Mm-hmm.
That was like really cool. I really like that. That's like a big set piece in itself. Mm-hmm. The backdrop like made most of the stage. I think like instead of like using a lot of like really big set pieces and having like an actual set, she substituted with like a huge ass like HD monitors, which were really awesome, but I feel like it could have been a little bit more to the stage.
Mm-hmm.
That, now I'm just thinking about it, but no, that was the biggest part of that performance. The vocals were really good, and her costume, I really like this costume a lot. I don't think it fits for some of the songs that she did, in particular, like it, which is coming up, so I won't get too much into it.
Yeah.
Oh, and I forgot, when Dance in the Rain, this is when she like came out with like my favorite costume. It was like that cat suit that was like all jeweled up and shit.
Yeah.
That's my favorite costume.
It had like a long skirt, but then they took it off.
Yeah, she took it off for the actual performance. Yeah.
That was really pretty. But yeah, piece in the puzzle, I loved. I really liked how they used the monitors as well, but yeah, they could have done a little bit more with the set. The set itself was pretty bare most of the time. In Piece in the Puzzle, she came out on like this really high pedestal. And yeah, I loved it. Like, it just looks, it's such a cool setup. Like, she stands out like a silhouette against like her giant face.
Yeah, that's basically what it was. It was just like she comes out from the stage on the rise. Like, the platform comes up. And that's the performance, guys. So there you are.
She comes out holding her ponytail. She's wearing like this big hair extension. She's just like holding it and like, she just looks like a boss.
Why does she do that so often?
I don't know, it looks cool.
I'm like, it's just like, okay. Like, I don't know, it's always a thing. Like, I don't know, like every time like someone has a hairstyle that's like a big old ponytail with like, you know, it's like long. Like, Nami did it too. Like, yeah. I wonder why.
Well, have you ever had a ponytail?
Bitch, no.
Well, if you had, you would understand that.
Okay, all right.
Maybe.
I'm missing an X chromosome.
Yeah. But yeah, when she came out in that outfit, I was like, okay, she hasn't given up on her whole sexy persona. She looks like a like bondage dominatrix, and yeah.
I got Mad Max from it, but I can see that.
Okay. Yeah.
I got Mad Max from that shit. Like that was cool. I mean, she's just missing, you know, the Charlize Theron, like the makeup, the smoky bald head. that was a great performance. And then it went into Fake Time, which that song is about a bitch that betrayed her. So.
Oh yeah.
And like my first impression when I first got the album, you know it because I posted it on my Tumblr, I said I thought it was about like her man like not like, you know, doing it right. I mean, it was a joke, but like, because I know she wouldn't be that explicit, but hey.
Well, she has been pretty explicit before.
I mean, yeah, but she's never been like, yo, he doesn't give me head right, like, you know. Well, that's something I think like that's something like a random Jay would say though, like. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you know, like, you know, random J-pop, that block.
Yeah.
I mean, no hate, but, like, I just got me pissed off. But I liked his Tumblr thing, and he, like, liked my, like, troll blog for a while, so I was like, all right.
Mm-hmm.
He ain't that bad.
Yeah, was that the song where she played the drums? Like, she opened up
Yeah, she came out playing the drums, and then she went out to the satellite stage on the catwalk playing the guitar. Well, she did the guitar really well. I think, like, the drums were, like, I mean, obviously she's not as small as these, but, like, she was, like, really slow with the drums. I mean,
yeah.
Hey, it's confusing, I get it. But it was cool. Mm-hmm. It was a nice touch.
Yeah, I like that. I like that song as well. And then we got another medley of Ningyo, Hime, and Freaky.
Yeah, no. I don't do that. We actually skipped... think we skipped something, didn't we? We skipped I like it. That's another highlight.
Oh Jesus. I keep skipping the songs.
It's okay.
God damn it.
I'm here. So yeah, like it. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I love the choreography for the song so much, but I wish she used a headset. She would have been able to do the whole thing, and I saw the whole thing because she, I don't know, this, I can't even find this on J-Pop Suki, but there was this performance that she does. this is a performance she does for it, where she uses a headset, and she does the full, like, thing, and it's, like, really sexy, it's really nice, it's really awesome. Her performance was really good, vocals really strong. She did most of the choreography from the music video, and I mean, that's mm-hmm. all I can ask for. It was really good.
Yeah. It was decent.
I liked it. It was one of my faves, actually, of the night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was. Because that's like my number one favorite song from the album.
Oh, okay.
So I was like, I was really looking forward to it. I wasn't too disappointed. I think maybe, I don't know. I liked it. I really did. I think it was one of my favorites. Yeah. 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 I'm convincing myself.
Well, Piece in the Puzzle is my favorite song off the album, so I liked the performance of that.
Good. And that one was, I think this whole segment was pretty good. It was just like the songs I didn't, like, once it hit Ningyo Hime, it went downhill for me for a couple songs. Yeah. Because I don't like, I guess we'll get into Ningyo Hime. I don't like Ningyo Hime, and I don't like Freaky.
Oh my god.
I think I like Ningyo Hime more than Freaky, and only because, like, she hasn't performed it as much, and Freaky, she does, like, literally every fucking show, and it pisses me off. And so the song is, I wrote this, that song is tired as fuck. So that's how I feel.
God damn it, Quinton.
I'm sorry.
I loved it. I love Ningyo Hime. That's, like, one of my favorite songs by her. I don't know, it could be my favorite song by her. So I don't get tired of it. I love Koo's rock songs, so.
I like them most of the time, yeah. Mm-hmm. I like No Man's Land, and I like Can We Go Back, and I like Ningyo Hime. I just, like, I don't know, like, I mean, I played it out or something, I just didn't like it, but, like, my favorite performance of the song was Black Cherry Tour, because she comes out, like, it's like, no, I'm not even getting into it. But, like, she comes out in a glass box, and, like, she sings the first part, and it's all a cappella, and then she breaks out of it. She's like,
That
was badass. That was really cool. I just didn't like her hair. It's just, like, slicked back, and then it's like, I don't know, I liked her hair. I didn't like the costume. It was ugly. Ugly.
Okay, well, then there was the band introduction. Did you skip that as well?
I listened to it. I don't care. I didn't write any notes on it. I don't care. I did it for Namie too when she had a band. I always skipped them except for Concentration 20. That one was really cool. I like the lady guitarist. She's like, she's cool. But anyways, that's not even the same tour. Let's go.
Okay, so there's another 2-part medley after that, and it was Taboo and Hot Stuff.
I love those two songs.
I love them both. And she fucking performs Taboo in a medley in every single tour since it came out. And
Except for Trek Tour. That's it. Yeah. That was the only time she did a full. And, like, that was the best performance of it, too. So, like, you're like, hold out for that one because it's so cool. Like, that was the first track. And, like, it's really cool. I like it. So, but yeah, it was really good. I wish she could have did the original choreography from the music video or Trick Tour, because it was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll understand why once you watch it. And if you guys watch it, you know what I'm talking about. And,
yeah. That's one of my, just want to say, Taboo is one of my favorite songs by her, so.
Yay.
Yeah.
That's a good song. And then Hot Stuff, she did the same performance, she did the same choreography since it came out. And I mean, it's kind of classic choreography at this point. Like, it's like, that's not gonna change. And, you know, she does the whole crowd participation. She, like, separates right to left, and they're all, like, you know, the guys are on the one side, the girls on the other side, and they're all like, yeah. So that was nice. I love the crowd participation. There's not a lot of, like, J-pop artists, I think, do that, so it's cool. Mm.
Did she, before, when she performed Hot Stuff, did she, like, because in this show, she goes over to one of the male dancers and, like, puts her head under his shirt.
No, but she like you. She usually like simulates oral sex.
Yeah. It's so, like at the same part in the video where she's like sliding down the guy. She's like.
She's like, yeah, that was gross. Like, shut up first. It smells like cheese. Like,
yeah.
I like that one. That one was fun. And then the next song was Bring It On, right?
Yeah.
I hate that song. I skip
it. Yeah, what the hell was that?
It's like not on an album. I don't know if it's like on a single. I don't know if I missed that one.
Was it a cover? I was like, I don't know what it is.
I don't know. It just came out of nowhere. And, like, she did it on Let's Party Volume 2, and then she did it, like, every show ever since then, and I fucking hate that song. It's like, come on, let's bring it. I don't even know how it goes. Like, that's how, like, I just remember, like, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-
Okay, another medley. Be My Baby with Loaded. Rode. Let's get Rode.
You're like, yeah, Rode. What do you think?
Well, I love Be My Baby, and I love the choreography in that.
Yeah, that's a fan favorite. That's like definitely like the crowd. That's a crowd pleaser.
Yeah.
I agree.
I hate Loaded. I didn't like
it. I love Loaded.
You like the album version?
I love the album version. I love the live version. I love it any version.
You're trash.
I said virgin.
I love any version.
I'm trash, whatever. I don't care. Like, I don't carry myself any other way. I'm not selling out the river at something else. Yeah, I love Loaded. I mean, like, Sean Paul, weird choice. I think they should just, but whatever. I mean, I think he did decent. It wasn't, you know, I mean, the last time I remember hearing Sean Paul before that song was, like, literally that song Temperature. Yeah. And I hated that song. So it's an improvement. And, I mean, she had, like, the worst English ever, like, I think ever in her career in that song. But I think that song is popping. Like, I think those two songs together somehow work really well. I think maybe, like, we could have did with the Be My Baby remix of it, though. Because I like that she does the studio versions because, like, that's the songs we know. Mm-hmm. But I think she can mix it up sometimes with that song. That song she never touched yet. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, I know it's a cover, but, like, you can remix covers, girl. Like,
yeah.
Right? Especially if it's, like, it's a song that, like, you know, everyone likes and like that. And, like, you know, they want, like, mm-hmm. that's a song, like, I know the dance, like, mm-hmm. and like, you do like a little funky version and be like, all right, and change it up, made the work with the medley. I feel like that's another thing. Like, she never like changed up the song to work together. If you're gonna do a medley, I feel like you should do like a, she only did it once, I think, and that was for the Bon Voyage tour. Those ones work together really well in that medley. The rest of them, she just cuts a song and then it goes on to the next song and it's like, oh, it's a medley. And with like a little segue in between, that's it. And I'm not feeling that. Like, just, mm-hmm. they're gonna do a medley, I think they should all run together and produce a medley as a mega mix, and like, they should be remixed in a way that there's a theme that all works together, that brings them together.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my critique. Otherwise, it's really good. I like that one.
Okay. I hate Loaded. It's a hot mess.
I mean, yeah, but... I know it's a messy song.
Conflicting tracks on it. Like, it sounds like two songs that are like, it just sounds like a mistake.
It doesn't sound like a mistake.
Yeah, it does.
Fuck that. So, and then it's the final song of like the main show, right? That's Life Is So Good. Life's So Good. Life's So Good. No participles there. Life's So Good.
Life's So Good. Life good, very good.
Like, it's life very good. Good.
Very good.
Very good. Life very good. Hey, how's everything going? Life very good. I was just telling like, I got it started or something. I don't even know what she says. I just hear I got it started.
Oh,
So I'm gonna say
I just farted.
I just farted. So I like that one. I think it's a good closing track, actually. It was nice. You know what? We'll get into it later. But I did see like on like the news reports when she was still in Japan and she did the show, like she did a hurricane. Mm-hmm. And it was right after like it, if not before it. And then she did this song and she was crying. Why did they do that show? She was like, and it was really nice because, you know, it was the end of the show and, you know, I think it was the tour final. I think that's what it was. So it like, either way, it was good. You know, it was nice. It was cute. I like to think that, like, you know, the new character that she's introduced to this new tour, Koop. Mm-hmm. I like to think that, like, Koop is, like, it's kind of like a collaboration between her. Because, like, you know, like, mask on, baby girl, mask on. I always think it's Koop singing.
Yeah, I love that part of the song.
Yeah, I think it's
so cute.
So, yeah, it was nice. I like it.
Yeah, at least it okay as a closer. Like, we know she's going to come back out for an encore. But it's kind of like a pump-up song in a way. So it's like...
Yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah, you know. Mm-hmm. I think, I don't know, I mean, like, because they were, like, supporting Walk My Life, it's a good closing, but I think I could think of, like, a billion more songs that would be better for that, mm-hmm. song, but not bad. So then,
yeah,
and everyone's, like, swinging their towels and stuff. That was fun. Mm-hmm.
So then we had another stupid-ass movie.
Yeah, I don't remember that one. I didn't actually write anything about that one.
Okay. So,
what did you have to say about it?
Well, to lead into the encore, it was kind of elaborate. There's, like, this, you know, the video where there's, like, the tube capsule things and, like, her outfits floating in there?
Yeah,
they kind of, like, go together, and then they go into, like, a thing, and then they, like, fly around. And then you see going across the screen, like, this rocket, and then the rocket actually, like, pops out in real life. It's like, that's pretty elaborate for an encore. They, like, built a rocket for the set, and it, like, comes out, and she's like, hey, there's, like, smoke coming out of it and stuff.
Yeah, that was cool. I did like that. I do remember that vaguely from my first watch of the show. Otherwise, my subsequent watches, I pretty much, like, because the interlude segments are sometimes, like, attached to the end or the beginning of a song. And usually it's at the end, so like if I like finish Life So Good and then I skip to the next song, I miss it altogether. I just hear her come out of the ship.
Oh, okay.
So that's where I said, like, comes out of a rocket ship, nice entrance. Mm-hmm. And I like most of the songs on the medley she comes out with. So on the medley, she does Lady Go, which is kind of a go-to for encores for her now. Mm-hmm. Wind, which kind of surprised me, but I like that song. So, okay. I'll Be There. I like that one. I think that's from Black Cherry, right?
I think so.
Butterfly. La 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 la. I fucking hate that song. Pop and Love Cocktail. You know, it was like the first half of that medley was good, and then it just like it just died. It was like a severe like 90 degree angle dive down, like
mm-hmm. like why did we have to hear La 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 and Pop and Love Cocktail again?
I know, La 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 wouldn't be so annoying if she did the whole like yeah in the beginning, and then she kept saying La La La, and I fucking hated it because like if you watch this story, you know what I'm talking about. That song was sang in a total of 3 times, but like 1 by the audience and 2 by her.
Yeah.
That song was 2 on the set list. Don't fuck with me.
I know. It's garbage.
I was so garbage. I mean, it was okay, but it was just like that could have been another song. Like,
yeah. I know, like give us something else, you cheap bitch.
I know, I was like, really? You're like, it was like she was like trying to promote this single all the time, which I get it, but it's like, I rip my eye out. Like, I don't know. I was like like, I was so mad, but I mean, whatever. I mean, that song is okay. I should stop being so dramatic. But like, the thing I hated the most was Pop and Love Cocktail.
Yeah.
No matter how you remix it, how you present it to me, I'm still gonna fucking hate that song. Mm-hmm. So fuck you.
I hate that song, and in my review, when I said I hated that song, like, so many people were like, oh, it's my favorite song on the album. It's like, what?
Oh, well, I'm sorry for your poor taste. Like, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to offend anyone. This is clearly a joke. I mean, I'm just bitch. Mm-hmm. Just bitch.
Life is so bitch. Okay. Yeah, I love Lady Go. I never get tired of that song live. I don't know why.
But it's a fun song.
It's so energizing.
And then it's like, and then she rides the shoe, yeah, and she rides it around the arena, the car, the obligatory car, and yeah. She got to step up the sign. This one's actually motorized. Because the one on the Happen S tour, it was like the one from like Color, it was like, it was in the shape of like the padded room from Color the Cover.
Mm-hmm.
But like her, her staff was pushing it. It wasn't even like a car, it was like a tower that like, they were like,
and like, push slaves.
Like, I know, like, where's the whip? And like, it was funny because I think at one point it kind of stopped and she didn't know why. And like, she almost like fell off. Like, mm-hmm. And it was like, you know, that's what would happen if this was the actual car, by the way. Like, maybe they were concerned about like, you know, like indoor fumes or something and like,
yeah,
emissions. I don't know. I don't care. I thought that was a little cheap, but this one was motorized and, you know, no one almost lost their life, especially not a major pop star.
Yeah.
It was good.
I liked her her little bit of butterfly she put in there, like her little dance that she was doing, like the original choreography.
Yeah. I love Butterfly. That's my favorite. I know, and I'm really, you know what? I'm gonna say this. I'm really glad I finally like watched a tour of hers that she didn't do Cutie Honey. I hate Cutie Honey. I fucking hate that song. I'm like, you know, I almost bought this because it's at my local record store. Like, I don't know why it's there,
mm-hmm.
but it's like this, it's this lunchbox of Cutie Honey, like from the movie.
Yeah.
That has the movie and then the soundtrack in it. And it has that version that she does, like Jill's like version that she actually sings in it, along with like the version that we usually hear and like other remixes of it. And like, I get it. I understand why people like it. And I liked it at one point too, but I would never like. I'm gonna have to say no to that.
Yeah, Al in the chat is saying he loves Cutie Honey, and I have to agree. Cutie Honey was the first song I ever heard by Koda Kumi.
Really, really.
Yeah. And I actually was singing
surprised.
It.
It's a really popular song. I mean, I would think you would have heard Taboo first, though.
No, that was a couple years later.
Hmm. Great. I'm glad. Hopefully your experience only went up from there, but I don't know.
Yeah.
So then the final song is Walk, of course. She always ends with Walk. She's like Ayumi Hamasaki. And those like 11 years that she ended every song, every like, well, she had it in the encore, at least Boys and Girls. Every time.
Mm-hmm.
Walk, I think it's good, but this one I actually like. So this one, Walk, I like a lot. I don't like this version of Walk. I really prefer the Affection version that she did up until Walk to the Future came out.
Mm-hmm.
When Tsukide came out. It's three times, not two. She introduced a new version of Walk. She like re-released it, guys. She like made it more piano and subtle. And like towards the end, there's like a gospel. like in the background while she's singing it. And it's nice. I just, I really prefer like the kind of like, oh, it's, Walk was never like a dance song, but it had dance elements to it,
mm-hmm.
dance slash electric elements to it, with a kind of a lovelorn guitar, if you will, playing along with her. And I liked that version a lot more. That was from her first album, one of the final tracks. I think second to last track. It's a great song. It's just I prefer the original version because I guess I'm a fag like that. But
mm-hmm.
Your thoughts, Wikipedia?
Well, I like, I kind of, I don't know, I guess I kind of like the more recent version of Walk a little bit more, just because I like her more newer-ish stuff.
I get it, yeah.
But, yeah, I like the song pretty well, but yeah, like, you obviously know before you even, like, look at the track list that Walk is going to be, like, the closing song.
Yeah, if not, it, like, if, yeah, I mean, I can't remember a time that it hasn't been, I'll have to look. But not pretty much every time. Yeah, it's like, mm-hmm. Walk is a closing track. And, you know, it's a good closing track, and I think she even, like, explained why she chooses that as her final track almost every time.
Oh, did she?
I don't remember. I had to look that up, but I do remember she did say at one point. I mean, this is like I said, this is the days when people, like, sub, like, you know, like, interviews, like, magazine interviews, like, TV interviews, and, like, you know, the fandom was, like, thriving. Mm-hmm. Now not so much because of K-pop. Sorry. No, K-pop is good. I'm just joking. But, like, it kind of took over and it's, like, overshadowed J-pop. That's why I'm kind of bitter. But that's why that's the one I found out why she did it. I had to look that up. But I think it was because, like, the song itself, like, it was, like, that was the last track that she did for Affection, and then she knew, like, that was, like, the song. Like, that was, like, she put everything into it, and then that was, like, her best song that she liked a lot. I think that's why, the reason why she does that one now is, like, it's just, like, really near and dear to her heart, and, like, mm-hmm. the lyrics kind of reflect that.
Yeah, so, that's cool. Yeah, like, it's been done to death, but at the same time, I'm still not tired of it. I'm not, like,
Yeah, it's a classic.
I still like it. Yeah.
It's definitely, like, a classic coup. Like, I mean, like, you don't get sick of, like, Cutie Honey. I do. But Cutie Honey, Butterfly, I know the Walk, even though that's an album track, it wasn't even a single. Didn't get a music video, didn't get anything. People know that song. That's, like, signature coup. Taboo, Red Cherry. I mean, sorry, Black Cherry. Oh, my God. I'm so sorry. Won't Be Long, Red Cherry version.
Mm-hmm.
That one is a very well-known one. These are, like, fan mm-hmm. favorites that, like, everyone knows, too. It's, like, public fan favorites.
Yeah.
And those ones are, like, those are it. So, I mean, you gotta do it. You gotta put them on the tracks. You gotta. And, yeah. That's one of them.
That's true. So, yeah, that was pretty much it. I really overall enjoyed this concert. I loved every single one of her outfits and, like, her hair and makeup, everything, except her eyebrows looked too, like, bright brown. I wish she had, like, purple eyebrows. Like, her hair was purple, her eyeshadow was purple, so I was like, you should have purple eyebrows. Or
yeah,
just,
she,
like,
did the mermaid, she did the mermaid thing for a second, right? She did the mermaid hair. It was nice.
Mm-hmm. And I can't remember the last time I saw one of her lives where I liked every single outfit. I think maybe on Bon Voyage I liked all of her looks. But, like, usually all of her concerts, there's, like, at least one look where I'm like, ew.
I'm not with, like, Namie as, like, that changed as of, like, maybe, like, I gotta say, like, 2010, that's when, like, she got her, like, fashion on. But, like, mm-hmm. there's this one costume that's, like, absolutely horrendous. And if I can, like, I'm gonna put up a picture and show you guys, and she did it twice. She did it fucking twice. It was like 2000, on So Crazy Tour 2003, hyphen 2004. She did this thing. It was like a tattered, like, it was a style back then. I give her credit. It was like, you know, it was the tattered, like, layered look, and it was like, it was a midriff showing bearing one, and then it had a skirt, and then she had black boots, and it was tan. And it was, like, different shades of tan, but it was, like, a nice fabric that had, like, you know, sequins in it. So, I mean, it was pretty if it was, like, just a skirt or something like that, but it was, like, the whole thing. And then, fucking next tour, she brings it back. She didn't even give it a rest, but it was blue this time. It's blue. And then, like, and then it was, like, that tour is known for, like, having, it had a lot of alterations. Like, the set list was a little bit different. Like, she took a song off, and, like, that was, like, one of her first tours. Like, she did, like, almost every track from the album, and she's been doing that since.
Mm-hmm.
That one only missed one track, and that was Free, and that's actually one of my personal favorites from her. It was on there for, like, I think, like, four shows, and then she took it off. And then for the release of the, like from the day that like she filmed the concert on, she brought back that dress thing, and but it was blue. And then she also changed one of the costumes, which was a corset type shirt with like, it was black and white, and then it had like white pants and like some like nice sneakers. It was one of the more dance heavy shows, and like that was like the dance heavy like part of the show that she wore that for. And it was a really like, I'm probably describing it and it looks ugly, but actually if you like look up pictures, it's really pretty. She changed that, and I mean for like another one, I was like meh. It was like a jumpsuit. It was like the J-Lo jumpsuit, but it was like white and black. So I had the same color scheme, but it was like I didn't like it. Mm-hmm. I wasn't gagging. So and then you know, and I was just like, you know, and look it up when you have the time. It fucking pissed me off. and ever since then it got better, but like that was like the epitome of like what the fuck. Like, and like, you know, I didn't even know that. Like if it was like the whole tour was like that, mm-hmm. fine. But she was inconsistent, like she had a great, and then it was like never mind. Mm-hmm. Like, never mind, I don't want to do right things. Like, it's kind of like that. But Aku, I never had a problem with, like, her outfits, except for, like, maybe mm-hmm. one of them. And I think it was, oh, that's right, it was a Black Cherry tour where she did the rock part. It was fucking ugly. And then, actually, there was another costume before that, before the show was recorded, like, when it was just a Domes tour and, like, in an arena. It was like a rainbow dress thing, and that shit was uglier. I don't know. At that point, I kind of lose hope.
We've been going for over an hour and a half, so
you can send to wrap it up. Yeah. General thoughts for you.
Yeah, so I really like this. I've been trying to figure out if it's like my new favorite live show by her, even though like Walk of My Life wasn't my favorite album. Mm. You know, like I felt like the performance really was strong, and like the sets and everything we talked about was really good. Just like the video clips were kind of boring, and some of the song choices, like we talked about, I was like, oh God. But I thought it was really, really good. So this is probably in like my top couple of favorite live Blu-rays that I have of hers.
Okay. Fair. it's not my favorite. I think it's really, really good. It's up there. Mm-hmm. Performance wise, I think like this is one of her best performances. It's varied, it's nice, it's pretty. Screens are awesome. See, I wish like people did it right where like they had a big show, but they also have really big screens. Mm-hmm. No, and I don't, you know what, they don't, like, it's, like, I think it's a budget thing where they have to, like, you know, either we're getting big tours or we're getting big shows, so which one you want?
Yeah.
And, you know, I think she made that choice or whatever, but, what's going on with this? I think either way, it worked really well. Most part, I think she had, like, nice surprises for people. I think this is, like, one of her best, like, tours where she did a lot of, like, cool things she never did before. She brought it, now I'm just waiting for the artist to come out later on this month, and then I'll really find out what's going on, because apparently that one's even like crazier. And there's a bath thing going on. I saw like one clip of it. I didn't want to spoil it for myself.
Oh, yeah. I watched like the trailer for that, but
It's really cool.
It looks really good, but isn't that like the small dome tour thing? Like,
No. What it was, two hall shows, and then two shows at Saitama Arena. Saitama Super Arena. Okay. I can't talk. So it was the same. It was literally the same show for the most part. Just like one was scaled down, and one was like bigger, and for like, you know, the recordings.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That was the impression I got, that it was like one of some of her smaller shows that she does for like fan club and stuff.
Yeah. No. It started out like just kind of like a smaller like. Two one night show things, and then it was already scheduled to be like the way it was. It was just like that's how it started, and then it grew. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But it was like same set list and everything. I already did the research and stuff, and okay. Actually, she unveils a new song called Cupcake on it.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be like a dance song. Okay, We'll find out, I guess. I mean, I think she's prepping for a new album. It's probably a best of album, honestly, because considering the tour that she announced, I mean, it's a best singles, right? Mm-hmm. Or is she doing all her singles? I don't know, but I think it's best singles, right? Mm-hmm. Whatever. I'm always excited for a coup tour. I wish the public cared about her as much as like they cared about her back then.
Yeah.
Back then, like, she was kind of like, she had, you know, she had different things. She was doing her own thing. No one was doing the same thing she was doing. She was an innovator. And then people forgot about that. Mm-hmm. Because she's still evolving and she's super smart. I mean, she's super smart. She has a good sense of humor. And I mean, everything she does is it's not like, this tour, she did, like I said, like she did a lot of throwbacks to like different like artists or different things she did in her past. Not a lot of other people did it, and she you know made it her own in a way, and it's coup, you know, it has that coup flavor. If you buy a potato chip bag, you know, it's like coup flavor. You know what I'm saying? Like you're always left with that impression. You don't feel like it's like a cheap knockoff.
Yeah,
and I think she had a bad rap, and we forgot about her after she had the baby, and like now she's struggling, and mm-hmm. it's not fair, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, after she had that like radio drama where she said that thing about like the rotting amniotic fluid, it seemed like everything just like screamed to a halt.
Yeah, and like, by the way, I researched that, and I know, like, she wasn't, like, right technically, but, like, I knew what she was getting at. Like, you should have children by 30, otherwise, like, you have a greater risk of, like, having a bad pregnancy. Mm-hmm. You do. You should have kids by the time you're 30. But, no, she was on decline by, before then, but, like, she's still, like, when she said that, Kingdom was being prepped for release, and she was already like she was promoting it when she was on that show, and the day after she had to issue an apology and they stopped all promotion for it, and that was like a couple months before that album came out, and it's still the number one. So she still sold a really good amount of money. So I don't even she sold a small amount of albums. So I don't really think that's even an issue. It was just more like, I feel like they chalk that up to it, but it's not that simple. I think it's just that, like, she might have, like, overexposed herself to the point, like, you know, everyone needs to, like, literally forget about her before, like, she can, like, and, like, do something, like, or, like, shocking and, like, really, like, you know, I don't know, comeback-y. Like, all her comebacks kind of, you know, you throw it and it, it just didn't work. It just always fell flat. And, like, I think she needs to do a really good comeback. And, like, you know, this 15th anniversary thing could have been her opportunity, but she did things that like are good for people, for the consumer, for the fans. So, you know, she did a lot of like one night shows. They were all like put on to like DVDs and stuff like that. Like we got like really good content. However, it wasn't good for like the public. It wasn't good for the GP because like no one really paid attention.
Yeah,
it wasn't anyone to get anyone's attention for. It wasn't Nami's 20th anniversary. What? Oh my God. Major domes tour, like literally everyone passes these places every day, and she has huge PR things that are done, and she has like literally zero like touch with it. All just like take out like one photo and like put the ad on, and then like it's like on every billboard, and everyone knows about it, and everyone cares.
Yeah,
and, like she didn't do anything like that. Like she did like some shows for A Nation, and only people who went to A Nation saw it.
Yeah,
or like only the people who went to Universal who bought a ticket for Universal and for that show when. So it wasn't like, you know, it was just weird. And like, you know, I don't know. I mean, it was kind of botched in the beginning. I don't know.
What happened that made her go down that path.
But I mean, like I said, it was good for the fans. Like we got some really great content, and we got like her best performance wise, not show, but like performance, like awesome. I think like her energy was great. Her dancing was great. Vocals great. It was just, you know, a lot of the performances that this era was really good. It was just like, something wasn't done right.
Needs to grow her fan base.
I think like at this point, I think she needs to like kind of like move and like do like something else. I mean, like you've been clamoring for like an American tour. Like, even if it's, like, at a con or something, like, just do that. Like, I mean,
yeah.
What is so scary? I don't understand.
Like, maybe it'll come.
One day it'll come. And like, I don't know, like, send her, like, some hate mail.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Let's get out of here. Okay. Yeah. So, this was super fun. This is, like, the funnest live show ever. So, maybe we can do this again sometime.
Okay, and we'll do it for artists or something if you want. I don't know. Maybe I'm making plans for you already.
Yeah. So you guys, make sure you thumbs up the video if you want Quinton to start his own YouTube channel. He did start one like a couple years ago, right?
Yeah, I did like some like stupid videos. Like it wasn't like stupid, like me acting stupid. It was like I like attempted and then I just lost interest really quick. But I'm not vlogging anymore, so I might get back into videos. And because I feel like it's easier for me. Mm-hmm. I have the right, like, well thought out responses and shade. I can just say it.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Do it.
Do it. Or, right now?
Anytime.
Okay. Remember that single cover that IU did and she looked like Namie? She still looks like Namie. By the way, at least she still has brown hair. And, like, she still takes pictures. It's like, yeah. What are you trying to be? Like, all right, dry clean.
My God.
Oh my God, my friend messaged me. Gabby messaged me and she's like, shout me out right now. How many people are like, shout out? She's watching.
Oh, hey, Gabby.
What's up, bitch?
What's up?
You can call her a bitch too. That's all right.
What's up, nice lady? Respectable female.
Oh my God, you're too late. Oh, I'm just joking. No, it's not that. Hikkipedia in house.
Yeah. Okay, so anyone who's still left in the chat, do you have any comments or questions or anything like that? Quinton, do you have any last words?
She says, what's good?
What's good?
Like, what's good? Yeah, that was really great. I hope you have me again. And, maybe you should buy LiveGenic, and then we can review that.
Yeah, actually, I'll buy it.
Because I'm, like, Japan. Really itchy to talk to someone about it. And I watched it. It's a really good show. I really want to watch it with someone.
Okay, we'll do it when I come back from Japan.
What is that, bitch?
It's like near the end of April.
Oh my God. Okay, fine. I'll just let you pirate it. Okay.
Oh, well, yeah, I could do that too.
All right. So, yeah, have me again. And thanks, guys, for watching.
Yeah, thank you, guys. Okay, see you next time.